So I never wanted to be an actor, I wanted to be a jockey, but yeah. I had a growth sort of 12, you know.
No shit.
I'm Irish and I love a few drinks as much as anybody. But I think as Irish we can be more than just the stereotypical alcoholic, although we can do that very fucking well. But that's how you test yourself, just in life, just pushing yourself against the best. I'd much rather get pushed to my limits against the best than win against a nobody. How many people do you see in life who have talent, live within that envelope, and never push themselves?
Because they sat there instead of
down there. And then you fuckers like us who have no talent.
That's it, we're just going out there and doing it.
We're stretching. Like, I'm already out on a limb.
Yeah.
I was out on a limb like 3 limbs ago. I'm Irish, I'm proud of my heritage. I think we're good fighters, we're good, humble, hardworking people. And I think we like to bring quality of life, personalities, and the quality of life, family, friends, and try to concentrate on the things that add to life. We're also a bit fucking nuts.
Yeah.
We push ourselves in hurling, football, soccer, cars, greyhounds, horses. We find something. I come from a place in Cork, where basically it's one of the most competitive counties in the country.
Yeah.
We cut each other's throats to win a game of football.
Yeah.
We cut each other's throats twice over to win a game of hurling.
Okay, yeah.
You know, so you come out to the big bad world, you go, hey, it's not too bad, these people are friendly, you know, so it's kind of like Sparta, where like they're pushing everybody against each other, but it's for the betterment, right? You know, so I think that's the balance in life, to, you know, the quality and your experiences, your friendships, your family, but you have to push yourself, you have to, whether you're a carpenter or an electrician, a race car driver, an actor, I'm a working class boy, and we get to finish a working day. There's a satisfaction. There's a tiredness you get by working for the man.
Yes.
There's a tiredness you get when you physically work, either on the building side or the physical tiredness you get when you push yourself physically or even mentally through study or you push yourself through an activity. That tiredness is a rewarding tiredness. You get that pain in the back of your neck from lifting a load, that's rewarding. The tiredness you get because you're data entry or you're just a number in that conveyor belt of the economy, that's the tiredness I think which drives a lot of negativity, drives a lot of challenges for people. But unfortunately in life, the hard work, the most rewarding tiredness doesn't always come with the most pay or the most results. How does evolution start? It starts by having a fish in the water going, what the fuck's up there?
Yeah, that's it. True.
You
know,
I'm going to dream of having legs so I can step up a stone. But he might not grow legs in his lifetime. There must be something in the DNA or the code that goes, I have an instinct to get up on that rock. And it might take a million years, but he finally gets up on that rock. And something there goes, do you know what? I'm going to get up that tree. And then if you trace back all mammals, fish, insects, you trace back that tree, like, there has to be something in the DNA. What for? They don't go to university and decide, I want to be a bird. There's something there that drives them to be different. The varieties of birds, the variety of mating rituals, the variety of carnivores, herbivores.
Yeah.
What drives that?
Yeah.
There's a code there somewhere.
I believe there is. I believe it all comes down to the universal energy.
Correct. So when humans decide to become an actor, a race car driver, an engineer, a photographer,
creativity.
So like creativity has its reward. Unfortunately, creativity doesn't always have its monetary reward. And usually creativity has to be dumbed down to sell to the masses. But creativity has its personal reward. It's a life experience. I think that's what, say, in your own acting career, Ryan, I think that's your potential, that's your power. a lot of people are like Justin Bieber, they get brought up and they're just manufactured. Then they get to a certain stage, they just drop off the planet. They've got no depth. I like to think guys like us have life experiences and we have these instincts and we find this joint instinct to drive forward as X-Wing pilots in the form of Ford or as a soldier and an actor.
Yeah.
Look at J.D. Salinger was in his 20s in New York, wanted to be a writer. Then he went off to World War II on D-Day. He was in Bastogne. He was a soldier. He had life experience. Then when he came back, he had that instinct to be a writer. He had his life experiences that he could draft characters with. So that, I think that's what we can do. You as an actor, you have key life experience. You know, you're a good-looking boy, but then and a funny taste in beauty, like
Yeah.
And I think diversity is a new interest.
Yeah.
Diversity is a new currency.